Yuri, guys, this is Gameboy Luke here, your coach for the Bristol City Blazerkins, and today we are facing off against Joey and the Bronx Beartics, or PokeMMD and the Bronx Beartics. I'm so nervous, dude. Oh my god. Last week you played against A-Drive, and I pretty much started the video saying, you know, I'm not really hopeful for much. And I'm going to say the same. You know, Joey's one of the best battlers we have in this league, and I'm terrified of battling him. It's going to be crazy. Let's see if we can't pull out a W. It'll be crazy if we can. I'm just not going to say anything. If we win, we win. If we lose, you know, we lost. It's fine. It's whatever. Before we start the battle, though, I do want to say very quickly, the Bristol City Blaziken shirts have now gone back on sale. There'll be a link in the description. I haven't got mine yet. I'm still wearing Haley's shirt right now, but I'm having mine sent in real soon, so hopefully I should have them by the next battle for next week. But let us dive straight into this. I'm going to get my phone ready so I can take a picture of his team. I am so nervous. Did I mention that? It's Joey. Of course, he brought the Kieran Black. Here it is. Hey, Kieran Black. How's it going? My phone won't focus on the screen. You know what? I can pretty much tell what they are anyways. It's not a problem. All right, so he's bringing the Kieran Black. He's bringing Reuniclus. He's bringing Manaphy, Snorlax, Aggron, and Garchomp. We are bringing... We're bringing Pokemon that I've used the sets for, like, already before. He's going to read the shit out of me. I am so bad at this. But we're bringing Being the Mew, Melody the Sylveon, Bork the Kyurem, Glover, the Hitmonchan, Sceptile, Gex, the Sceptile, and Azure, the Gyarados. This is going to be interesting because, like, my team, like, the sets I've got on Mew and stuff are pretty much the same stuff I've been using. I want to predict that he's going to read me to lead off a Beanie. Rocks is going to be super useful for fighting Kyurem with. I think I want to go into something. I don't even know what I want to lead with because Mew's like my go-to thing, but I don't want to read me. At the same time, what can he do against it? So I'm going to be predictable. I'm going to play straight into his hands. At this point, can I do much else? I'm just going to lead off with Mew because I think it's pretty obvious that I'm going to do that. But last night I was Skyping Joey and I was psyching him out and I was telling him I was going to bring all these weird sets and stuff, which I haven't really done. I've just kind of brought some pretty standard stuff because I'm pretty sure Glover is almost the same set as last week. Mew and Sylveon are pretty much the same sets as last week. Which makes me super predictable and easy to read. I understand that, but I actually am heading out to a convention. Actually, as you're watching this, I'll be already at the convention in London. So I didn't have a great deal of time to team build. I kind of just went YOLO and just kind of did it. He leads with the Snorlax. That's kind of interesting. I'm looking at his team. He doesn't really have anything. He wants to take a Will-O-Wisp unless he goes to Reuniclus. Because I'm pretty sure it gets Magic Guard, right? So he would want to be burn. So what we're gonna do actually, dude, he's got his mega as well. I wanna go for Stealth Rocks. I wanna get Stealth Rocks up straight away, right? Just because Kieran Black is there. And Kieran Black can't keep running in and out of the team and being a butt. He's gonna body slam me. If he paralyzes me, it's gonna paralyze him as well. That'd be cool. Holy fuck, he got the crit from the start. That is great. I'm just throwing that out there. That's fantastic. That's a great start to this battle. Leading off the first attack of the game, and he crits me. Marvelous. It's fine. It doesn't really matter that we're paralyzed, though, because I do have access to Heal Bell. That's not a problem. One thing I do want to double check, though, is how much that move was meant to do to me. So I can figure out whether or not he's Choice Band or not. I think he might be Choice Band. Let's go to Beanie. Let's get this Snorlax out right now. Choice Band Snorlax would have done. Body Slam would have done. Let's see, he's not even using Return. He's using Body Slam, right? Should have done 46% to 43%. It definitely did about half. So I want to think he's Choice Band because he critted me right there. But at the same time, I think he's banded. If he's banded, all he's got right now is Body Slam. And we could go into Azure and maybe do some shenanigans over there. But what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna go for Knock Off real quick. I mean, we're gonna be faster than him. He's gonna withdraw actually, and go into who? Hard Body. Okay, that's fine. We're gonna get a free Knock Off on Hard Body. I'll take that. Catch this. He has the berry. Okay, so we know. That's fine. Okay, cool. Now, what do we want this guy to do? What even is this thing? Reuniclus. What is this thing gonna do? Should I set up Calm Minds maybe? Let me think about who I've got on my team right now who can deal with this. Could go to Azure. He might try and set up a Calm Mind. We could go to Azure. If he wants to set up a Dragonite's Crunch, maybe. Or we could go into Melody, because Melody has... What would Melody do? How much would Melody do to this? Melanie's high boys do at 45%. We can either heal Bell as well. If he wants to calm mind, he could potentially Psy Shock us at plus one. That's gonna do like 68% to us. So I'm gonna go into Melody real quick. Let's just switch into her. All right, be right back, dude. So I'm gonna switch out. His Culber Berry's gone now, so at the very least, Garchomp can come in and crunch this thing into the next dimension. He goes for Psychic, so he doesn't have Shiny Psy Shock, it's Psychic. So I'm gonna have to eat that. That's yummy, actually. It's really, really tasty. I do feel like I should get rid of the Paralysis on Mew, because it might play a pretty big part later on in the game. So I am gonna go for the Heal Bell just to get rid of Paralysis, because I think, you know, a slow-ass Mew is probably not really that much of an issue, but I do not want to fuck around with all that shit. So he's gonna bring back in this. He's gonna bring the Snorlax back in as I go for the Heal Bell, because I definitely don't want Paralysis on Mew. Because if I want to set my, if I don't go for a Will-O-Wisp at some point, I definitely don't want to be paralyzed. I'm not messing with Hex. Sorry, I'm just not messing with it. If this guy was to Body Slam me, let's just pretend. I'm pretty sure he's Choice Band. That would do. Oh my goodness, Return would kill me. Body Slam probably won't, but it's gonna do a lot of damage. What do we do? Let me think. He might be fully parried. I'm just trying to think of a Pokemon to go, which would be the best Pokemon to go into to deal with this thing. And because we can't burn it, it's gonna sit here paralyzed. I think he kind of wanted me to. Like, that's the reason he screwed himself up like that. Let me see here. We have Azure, our Gyarados, real quick. A waterfall with him would do so much damage. What does Mega Gyarados have? Mega Gyarados. Check his base stats real quick. So I might better switch into Mega Gyarados, get Intimidate off, and then start setting up. Or just go for a straight up attack, to be honest. Mega Gyarados is, I'm just checking his stats now, with an attack like 125. Wait, is that Mega Gyarados? No, that's not even Mega Gyarados. Like, if I boost his Mega, it's 155. It's gonna do a hefty amount. I'm gonna go into Gyarados. I'll get the Intimidate off as well. Wait. Oh, he's gonna read the shit out of me. Snorlax can get a Thunder Punch, right? Facade! Bruh, what the f- Okay, he has Facade. Welp, that's not funny. Even with the Intimidate, that did buku damage. Do I just Mega Evolve and go for Waterfall and see how much damage I can do? I honestly think that's the only option I have. That's such a clever set. Facade, Snorlax, he got the Paralysis, so I played straight into his hands. Damn it, dude, that sucks. I'm gonna Mega and go for Waterfall, because if we can... He's gonna withdraw. Okay, he's gonna withdraw. Who's gonna go into? Strongjaw? Is that his... Garchomp, okay, that's fine. So if he sent this out, I wanna believe that he is potentially, he's probably Choice Scarf. I should have D-danced here. He's probably Choice Scarfed. I'm gonna hit him with a waterfall regardless. Let me just throw this at you real quick. That's doing some hefty damage. That was a crit. That's a crit for crit. You know, that's pretty fair. In all honesty. At this point though, he is. Do I want to save Azure? Because Choice Scarf Chomp is going to mollywop me, to be honest. He doesn't even have to go for anything crazy. He can just go for Earthquake at this point, and that's going to do mad damage to me. So, I mean, I could try and predict and switch into Melody. But let's see what Mew can do at this point. He might go for Earthquake. With Mew set right now, Earthquake's going to be like 35%. Which I believe I can take two of I have Roost and I have Leftover. So I'm gonna switch into Beanie right here. I think Azure might come in handy later on, because if we get the opportunity to set up, he might be useful. So if we go into Mew, come into your boy Mew, I wouldn't imagine he's going for Outrage. He went for Dragon Claw? He straight up goes for the offense. That's wild. That's wild. I don't know what to do now. That's really strange. I feel like he's gonna switch out right here, and I wanna go for a Willow, because I think he's gonna switch out into something else. He might go to Snorlax though. So I don't wanna. I don't wanna get HP up, but I don't wanna get him free switch. He went for D-Claw. I could have gone to Sylveon. I mean, he might be locked in. He might have poison jab. That's another thing. Like, I can't really strongly confirm that he has, or that he is, Scarf. So I'm gonna go for Roost as he withdraws. So we're gonna get our HP back up on Mew. I wanna keep Mew healthy. He goes into Hard Body. So I'm gonna do this. Let me see. Ryu Nicholas. If I do this, right? He's got Psy Kick instead of Psy Shock. Psy Kick. So pretty much a full now, actually. That's really good. Knock off without an item. He's only gonna do like a quarter of his health. Is it really worth it? Is he gonna throw a psychic at me? Like, he threw a psychic at me last time. I could try and make that prediction and go into Gyarados this time. Although he may just go for like a Shadow Ball or something. I'm gonna try this. Joey obviously is a smart player. He probably isn't gonna use the same moves he did last time, but I'm gonna go into Gyarados and we'll just see. I'm just fucking testing the waters right now. I break the mold and he goes to Signal Beam predicting the Gyarados. I had a funny feeling. I've got to play much more smart. I need to probably concentrate on my moves. I think I'm rushing into this a little bit. So, but with that, we do have a free switch in right here. So let me just see real quick. I have a few tricks up my sleeve. I do have a few tricks up my sleeve. If I need them. Let me see if I go to your boy. I go to Kyurem. Do bring Kyurem. Draco won't kill this thing, so I guess he doesn't really have much reason to stay in. To switch out, rather. We really don't have much to deal with this thing, actually. I think the best thing we can go into is Melody. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go into Melody. Just typed in Melody into the damage calculator. If you go into Melody, I mean, Hyper Voice is gonna do like 45%, which is a nice chunk of damage. At the same time, do I think he's gonna stay in? Does he wanna take that damage? You can quite easily go to Snorlax, quite easily go to Aggron. So I think what I wanna do right now is just Baton Pass, because I think he's gonna switch out. So I'm gonna Baton Pass, let's see what he does. He withdrew, okay. So he's gonna withdraw, goes into Panzer, which is his Aggron, which is cool. I'm actually just gonna, I had a funny feeling he'd go into this thing. I'm not really sure how much would it have done to Aggron. What would it have done to Aggron? A Hyper Voice would have done like 25%. At this point, what I can do actually is come into Gex and Focus Blast this thing. Let me see what Gex is. Can Gex kill this thing in one hit? Let me turn this to Mega Aggron. I don't think it can. You go OU Tank. A Focus Blast only does like half health, so it's not worth going into him right now. And the best thing we can do is go into Beanie. Potentially get the Will-O-Wisp off. He's probably gonna switch into Snorlax, predicting it. I think he's gonna go into Snorlax, predicting it, so I really want to go for knockoff at this point. Because he must have an answer for this. So Heavy Slam's gonna do like 35% to me. I think I'm gonna go for knockoff. I'm gonna go for knockoff, so I don't think he's gonna stay in. A knockoff, obviously, you can't knock off a mega, like the mega stone. So if he switches into Snorlax or he switches into something else, I can get the knockoff and I can clear a hold item off of something. I've already got rid of Reuniclus's hold item. Aggron's got the mega stone, so we can't touch that. If he wants to go into Kyurem Black, which actually you probably wouldn't want to do because I want to burn him. Yeah, so he switches out. So I'm gonna get a knockoff a free item right now. I'm probably going into Snorlax. Oh, he goes into Hard Body. That's true, because I can imagine he wouldn't want Hard Body to get too... Oh, because he has Magic Guard, that's why. So, with the knockoff, though, we've done a pretty nice chunk of damage right there. At this point, I'm more than free to just go back into Melody, to be honest. We can do this whole switcheroo kind of game. Unless he has HP Poison. I've never seen that before. I mean, I'll still eat that up, actually. I literally have no reason, because this thing walls this game. It doesn't look like he has Psy Shock, so I can sit here and wall the fuck out of him. With Sylveon. As he uses Recover. Okay, interesting. But I want to just go for the raw hyper voice at this point. Let me see here. Ryu necklace. Like, I'm just gonna go for hyper voice. I'ma just hit him, to be honest. See what he does. Cause I honestly think Joey, I'm not a great battler, but I wanna assume that Joey, you know, he knows my skill level, so he might be able to kind of predict what moves I'm gonna be using after the way I'm playing. Like, if I would do the same thing twice. So I'm trying to think outside the box, if anything, and try and do things that maybe I wouldn't normally do. I would be so, you know, I would probably just go for baton pass here in a regular situation, but because I'm trying to get in his head, that's the thing. So if I hyper voice right now, we'd do 45%, which isn't a great deal. But at that point, I don't think he'll want to stay in. He could keep recovering and we'd be in an endless loop. But at that point, I could probably switch out into something. Let's see. Let's see what he decides to do. He does withdraw again. I could have gone for baton pass. He comes into Panzer. Panzer! Hey, how's it going, Aggron? He wants to get this Mega, I think. This Hyper Voice, let's see what this Hyper Voice can do. Not a great deal whatsoever. But this thing can't recover, and he doesn't have Cleric on his team. This thing can't recover, and he doesn't have Cleric, so... he's gonna Mega Evolve, and he's gonna set up something. He's gonna do something. What does Mega Aggron do? This is weird, because it's a Pokemon I don't... see very often. So Stealth Rocks, raw toxic maybe? I can maybe see toxic. He's probably gonna want to heavy slam this thing. I mean, I'm not gonna stay in, obviously. I really wanna burn it. But with the hard body thingy running around, we can't really do much to it. So I'm gonna come into Mew again. And he's gonna Mega Evolve. I think I might go for Will-O-Wisp this time. I can't really paralyze him anyways. So maybe going for this Will-O-Wisp might be able to mess them. Get some Stealth Rocks up. Do I have a spinner? I do have a spinner, we're fine. So he finally gets his rocks up. I'm just straight up gonna go for the Will-O this time. He's probably just gonna go into Hard Body. I probably should predict that and do something else. He knows I'm gonna go for the Will-O, so I'm gonna get the Will-O. It's not a problem. I haven't got anyone that can use Toxic or anything anyways. So it doesn't bother me. How much does Signal Beam do to me, actually? I don't know why he has Signal Beam. Is it a Shadow Ball? Oh, yo, Signal Beam is a lot. Goodness. I mean, he can probably predict the switch into Melody at this point. And go into Aggron, maybe. I don't want to give him that opportunity, though, so I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go for Knock Off. Okay, so what did he read? What did he predict? He just went out straight for Psychic. I'm going to eat. So that's not a problem. This is weird. I'm gonna go for Psychic now. I'm gonna go back into Melody. I'm trying to figure out if he's choice or not. I don't think he's choice. That would have done much more damage if it was choice, I suppose. As he goes for Calm Mind. Here we go. Here it is. Here's the Calm Mind Reuniclus. Now that we don't have... Oh, shit, he's gonna sweep me. Now that we don't have Gyarados, this is definitely a problem right now. I don't have any physical attackers to destroy this thing, and he has recovery. He's in a very, very good position right now. This is like a red alert moment right now. Shit. This is not good. Melody. Sylveon. Psychic's still only doing 22% to me, though. Hyper Voice will do, 30. But I guess I want to put him in the position where he can recover so I can get a safe switch into someone else. Yeah, he's only for a cup. Fuck. Okay, what do I do? I don't have anything. Honestly, the only physical attack I had was my fucking Gyarados, and it's gone. Shit, I did not think about this. Did not think about this. Now I'm screwed. He's pretty much free to just set up on me. I have nothing for it. Shit, dude. I have nothing for it. Oh, this is not good. This is not good. He can just set up on me, and I really don't have a physical attack. I actually don't have anything for this. I did not. Didn't even think about Reuniclus. I'm actually stuffed. I'm actually screwed right now. I think I'm boned. I think I'm boned. He can psychic me all day. It's not gonna do anything. I don't know why he's not setting up more Carmines, because I really can't do much to him. The only physical attacker I have is Glover. This thing's probably bold, and it has Thunder Punch for fucking Manaphy and some of his mons that I was expecting him to bring. How do I get past this thing? How do I get past this thing? The Glover's not touching this thing. I actually think that if he leaves this Reuniclus in, there's nothing I can do. There's nothing I can do. Unless I go into Kyurem. And I try and Draco it. I have Shadow Ball on him. I could try that. How much is that going to do to him, though? Focus Blast will kill Psychic, won't. I'll get 100 HP back, so I can probably give it a shot. I think it might be worth a shot. Let's try it. Let's give it a shot. That's so... Oh my god, that's such a pain. I did not even think, like, I was thinking about Kyurem Black, I was thinking about Garchomp. Never forget about the hard body. He's probably got Focus Blast as well, actually. Hold this pressure, B. As he goes for another Carmine, yeah. Fuck me, we're done. We're so done. Unless I can get a crit or something, we're pretty much boned at this point, because his Reuniclus can just sweep my whole team. Without my Gyarados, we're done. We're done. Without my Gyarados, we're done. I'm gonna Shadow Ball it. It'll do 30%, so after like four hits, I need to kill this thing. Plus he has Recover, so I'm just stuck. We're stuck in this endless, he could pretty much just win with this. I'm gonna get 6-0'd. I knew it was gonna happen. We're gonna get 6-0'd, I can't do anything. We're so boned. I screwed up so bad. That's what you get for rushing sets, peeps. That's what you get. He's just gonna recover because he can get the HP back. I'm so done. We need a Gyarados. I shouldn't have sacked him. We just have to sit here and just wait. There's nothing I can do. I have 5 Pokemon that can't touch this thing. I screwed up, guys. My team was terrible. There's nothing I can do. Unless I can get a Spadef drop, unless I can get a crit, we're pretty much out of the game now. I really let the team down this week. I really did. That's the problem when you have other things going on in your life. Oh, there's a crit, boy! There it is. We just put him in range to be killed. Yo, Kyurem's dying words. Don't get 6-0'd. Bruh, wait, hold the phone. Yo, Sceptile, come save me, B. I could bring Sceptile in power. How about I have Solar Beam this thing and finish it off? I think that's the only Pokemon I can kill it with right now. Okay, let's go into you. Hey, what's up? My name's Sceptile. I'm here to attempt at fucking up your shit. Solar Beam will kill from this range, I think. So you wanna give it a shot? I think we should just give it a shot. I think we should just hit him. Let's just do it, dude. Catch the Solar Beam, let's go. bruh. Fully charged due to the power herb. Let's go, bro.
Please go.
Yes, we're not 6-0 thanks to a crit. But I'm down to like no Pokemon out now. I have nothing. CBB is his Snorlax, right? This is the only thing I had to take the fucking Reunicus down. And the whole point of this Pokemon is for the Yumburden boost, which is pretty much useless at this point. I can Focus Blast him and just see. What would be the smart move, Luke? What would be the smart move? I can't. There's no smart. I can't do anything. I can't. I'm just going to Focus Blast him. We're just going to hit him with it. And we land. Boom. Let's go, lads. Let's go. That's a mean damage right there. Be paralyzed. Oh, this is a facade. I'm dead. Goodbye, Gex. I can't do anything. Like, there's nothing else I could switch into to finish him off right here. I can go into Glover. So look, his Reunicus is down. Actually, you know what? Glover puts in some work right now. Glover puts in some work right now. Who do you want to switch into? I'll close combat them to the next dimension, dude. I'm done, dude. I'm so done. If I was to use Mach Punch, I just typed in Glover. No. If I was to use Mach Punch would kill this thing. Mach Punch would kill this thing. I don't want to go. Should I go for a close combat anyways? Yeah, Mach Punch will kill. Let's go for Mach Punch. Sack this thing off. Do it. All right, cool. I don't want to use my close combat just yet, boys. Hey, Snorlax is down. Okay, next. Who wants some more of this, dude? Who wants some more of this? Let's see how much we do to Mega. I don't honestly think Mega Aggron's gonna wall the shit out of this Pokemon. There he is. UU Tank, let's see. Mega Aggron, close combat, there's 42%. And he will do. Yo, he doesn't kill me. We should Mach Punch and then we should close combat. Actually, we should Mach Punch and then close combat. I reckon we might be able to kill it. Hey, yo, let's do it. Let's give it a shot. Okay. Goes for Thunder Wave. What? Aggron gets Thunder Wave. Why does he get Thunder Wave? Don't understand. Okay, so now if I go for close combat, it kills. So let's just go for it, dude. Let's just rock out. Heavy Slam, boys. Is it flinch? Does this move flinch? I think I live. I do live. Close combat comes through. Fuck out of here. What is this match? What is this match? I thought I was going to get 6-0. Alright, Aggron. Get out of here, dude. Get out of here. Alright, so we can Mach Punch Garchomp. And then there's Manaphy and Kyurem to deal with. Bear Ticks. Okay, this is the Kyurem. Oh no, it's the Manaphy, of course. Okay, so this is my thing. We have a this is probably Tail Glow, right? Shit, it's probably Tail Glow. I want to preserve. I want to go into Melody right now. Yo, what is this match? What is this match? Okay, Skull to Hitmonchan doesn't do a great deal. Melody, let's see what it does to Sylveon. Melody. It's gonna do like 20%. I'm gonna go in fucking Melody. Let's go. I need this thing if I want to take down Garchomp and I want to take down Kieran Black. So if anything, right now, once again, Hitmonchan is my win condition. So I take the rocks damage. He's gonna go for Scald. It's gonna do like 20% tail load. Okay, of course he would. Why wouldn't he? How much does that boost by? That's plus 3 straight up. Okay. Okie dokie. Hyper Voice is gonna do like 50% of this thing. Could just throw 2 of those out because I can take 2. Am I faster? I'm not faster. I need to wish and pass it on, but it's not gonna work because he's gonna kill me before I get a chance to do so. This happened last match. Wait, hold on, let me check. Glover doesn't die to rocks because he resists them, so we're fine. I think I should just go for Hyper Voice and then maybe come in do it with Hitmonchan. With Mach Punch, we'll do 20. Oh, yeah, I think we're boned. I think we're boned at this point. Because if I wish, he goes to Scald, it's 50% or so. I don't Alice Feed this thing, so he's free to... okay, I'm gonna Hyper Voice. I can't do anything else. Because he's gonna Alice Feed me. This comes up with the Scald. It's gonna do mad damage to me. We go for Hyper Voice. Oh, he's got special defense investments. He's got special defense investments, so I didn't do as much as I wanted it to. And I was on 140, wasn't I? So that did about 80 damage to me. God damn, I have no idea. Just out of curiosity. Scald is 81% to me. Holy shit, and it's gonna be faster than me as well. Shit. So if anything, actually, what I wanna do... It's got special defense investments. I don't know how... If I get a min roll on this gold and I get the hyper voice off, I might be able to kill with Mach Punch. Oh my fucking god, I did get the min roll. That's hilarious. I should have wished first time. Leftovers to save me. I got a min roll. I can take this thing out now. He's gonna scold me to finish me off, right? I'm gonna go for a wish, just in case he does switch out or something. I mean, he won't switch out, but... Because he's thinking about what he wants to do now, because he's in range to be killed by Mach Punch at this point. So I can come in with Mach Punch, take this thing out, and then deal the rest of the Pokemon. Let's go to the Scald, okay. He's gonna get some leftovers recovery right here. Mach Punch is going to do 29 to 30%, which will kill this thing. Will kill it. What I'm expecting him to do at this point is I'm going to Mach Punch, and then he's going to switch into Garchomp. And Garchomp is going to easily rough skin. I didn't kill! No, it didn't kill. Mach Punch says there's like 35%. He must be a bulky set. He must be the bulky set. The leftovers saved his butt. Damn it, Joey. This match was crazy, dude. I thought I was getting 6-0. You know what? I'll take a 3-0 for Joey. I will take the 3-0 for Joey. Actually, you know what's funny? I think I might even live this. I think I'm gonna live this, and then I have to try and deal with the rest of the Pokemon with just Mew. Hit me with that skull, do it. Fucking, don't burn me though. That would suck. Oh, 29%! Ah, the burn, no! Why'd the burn click now? Of all times. Actually, wait, no, it's not even a 3-0, it's a 2-0. Boy, it didn't even kill. So it's good that he did burn me, actually. I needed the burn, otherwise he wouldn't have died. Dude, this bulky Manaphy, I had no idea. 2-0 victory. We got the 2-0, man. 2-0 loss. Yo, send out Garchomp. Actually, no, I think Garchomp's got... I mean, Mew is slower than everything on his team right now. He's gonna do it with beatdown. All right, you bastard. Hit me with your best shot. Yo, go for a move that has, like, accuracy. That reduces accuracy or something. I'm gonna go for Roost, dude. Okay, I'm gonna go for Roost right now. He's probably just gonna go for... He's gonna go for Dragon Claw. He's playing it safe. Damn it, Joey. What even was that match? I don't even know what it was, dude. Oh, that was fun. That was really fun. I really enjoyed that. It was so stupid, dude. Oh my goodness. If you guys enjoyed, please leave a like rating down below. I really appreciate the support. The Bristol City Blaziken. I let you down this week with a little bit of a tricky... It was a terrible team, let's be honest. I'm going crazy. Oh my goodness. Check Joey's link in the description below to go check his perspective out. I never claimed to be a Wi-Fi battler, okay, or a competitive battler. The giraffe was pretty booty. The team was pretty booty. People were telling me to bring Lucario and stuff, and I probably should have, but I was being stubborn and was like, no, I want to use Power Herb Sceptile because he's cool and I haven't really used him yet, so screw it. So for those of you in the comment section, they'd be like, oh, you should have used this Pokemon. I know, I'm getting help. Shout outs to Victor again, by the way. I'm getting help from fans when building these teams, but I'm also trying to, like, include my own flavor as well at the same time. So it's like, I'm just chilling. You know, I don't really mind about losing, to be honest. We beat Dan last week. It seems, I don't know if I'm correct in saying we've gone loss, win, loss, win, loss now, right? So we'll do a win next week anyways. So there's no problems, right? Right? If you guys enjoyed anyways, please do leave that like rating down below. It'd be really appreciated. And don't forget also, the Bristol City Blaziken's merch is coming out, or is out, and you can click the link in the description to get one of those if you want to support the team for next week. But yeah, thank you all so much for watching one last time, and I'll see you guys next week.